Thank you. Thanks very much. Pierre's work next door in the exhibition with his partner, Pierre DeWitt, explores architecture, originality, and the question of exhibits explicitly in the last few years, and we thought it an excellent addition to this year's public program for the ways in which Pierre and his partners explore the production of exhibitions and not just buildings as a part of their larger architectural project. The exhibition methods, which was curated, by the way, by a recent A graduate, Cédric Libert, explores through the various notebooks, travelogues, sketches, diaries, collages, text, the various ephemera of the opus, the ways in which an architect today can exhibit his or her work. And Pierre will be saying more about that as part of his presentation tonight. The difference, as he says, between making architecture and showing it, which is something that his, the office is greatly interested in. As you know, two book atlases have been produced as a part of the exhibition. We're very pleased that one of those was produced here through AA Publications. They'll be on sale, by the way, at the end of the talk around the corner. Charlotte Newman from the AA bookshop will have them on sale here in the South Jury Room, which will open up after this. Pierre obtained his diploma in 1981 from the Institut Lambert-Lombard in Liège. And the following year opened his office, which he directs to this day. In 1996, Pierre and the office represented Belgium at the Architecture Biennale in Venice. And in 2002, he was awarded the Baron Horta Prize for the creation of Max at the Grand Hornu. Pierre Hebbelinck.
Thank you. Mesdames, Messieurs, bonsoir. I would like first to say two things. The first is that I would like to thank you, Brett, and all AA to have this exhibition here and to think about our work with this way. And another way to think about what we try to do is this lecture, in fact. And the second thing, is I'm really afraid to give a lecture. Because I'm not a teacher, in fact. I never teach, and it's difficult for me to explain my work, in fact, in such a way. But I will try to do, and the third is to apologize because you heard that it's not my language, English, and I have a real bad English, but I will try to explain what I want to explain now. And I'm 52 years, I have two children. The first is Simon, he's a young carpenter of 21, and my daughter is 23, and she makes makeup in Paris, in fact, for theater and for cinema and so on. And I began my work of as architect in 82 with my own office, in fact. And during all this period, I have 80% of my project were broken by administration and stopped and refused and so on. And but I, at the end, I built everything, all the orders. It's one of the reasons why I don't teach. It's impossible for me, in fact, to teach in Belgium, actually. And another thing I wanted to say first is that, in fact, I have two ideas when I come here with you. The first idea is to, a strange idea perhaps, because I have the idea when Brett asked me to give this lecture. I was in a lecture, in a reading of a book, and the title of this book of the German writer Walter Sebald was in French, you can see it there, Destruction as Element of Natural History, or the Story of Natural. I don't know how to translate. And in fact, what made Walter Sebald, he tried, he made a research about, he did a research about the situation of the writers after the Second World War. And in fact, we can see in the novels, of the in the books in Germany that nobody, no writer speak about the destruction of 127 city by the Allied army in Germany. And he tried to explain this phenomenon, in fact, why so much writers don't speak about their own suffering, if you want. And there are two big reasons. The first one is that the first who stayed there during the war don't want to speak about it because it was so intense, the suffering was so intense that it was impossible to speak about this. They wanted to write about what to do after the war, what to do after all this terrible period for them. And the second one was who come from abroad and who with the culpabilities that it was impossible for them to speak about the suffering of others, for example. And what I wanted to explain with this, in fact, at the same moment, I was reading this 2 months ago, at the same moment, in 1 week, I received two persons who speak with me about a problem of a building I built 5 years ago in the center of Brussels. This is the name of this building is the House of Citizens. In fact, this is a program that I will expose. But this building in 5 years was really attacked and not destroyed, but with a lot of problem of aggressivity. And I begin to think about the lecture, and perhaps we can speak about architecture to try to find a meaning with the city, with the scale, with I don't know, with the light, with the structure, with a lot of things, perhaps with all these things. But what I try to do is to perhaps also to observe another position for myself first, and after that to explain. But how to give the question a good question, to think about a problem like architecture, and perhaps the destruction of the alteration. I don't know if I can speak like this in English, but yes, you understand my way. Perhaps it's a good question to think about my own practice. It's to see what appears when a building is attacked, for example. Yes? What is the meaning of this? And after that, I will explain five of six, perhaps very quickly, teams through six of our projects. But before, I want to explain these things. Yes. 15 years ago, I rent a studio, artist studio, if you want, yes, during 1 year and a half. And my idea was to do, in this studio, to do nothing. And I do nothing. Why? Because it was a place to sing and to think about what. In fact, with all the problems I've shortly described with the project, the way to create is really hard for me with my own project, with the project of the Atelier. Okay. And for me, perhaps there is some solution about this to create. And perhaps the poetry is everywhere, the daily poetry is everywhere. But what to do with the daily poetry? And my idea, and it's a part of the book you have described, Method, a part of this book, because I've tried to find some reflex to see the poetry to the daily life, if you want. And for example, there, I think I'm the age of my son. Yes, we are in 92. Yes, he was 5 years old. And I don't know why, but I have the idea to take pictures, photography of his body, but around the perimeter of his body. And I take for this, I don't know the English term for this kind of camera, but camera that I can throw away. Yes, you know it. Stupid camera, more stupid, there are not. This one. Okay. And I take this one, and I take picture of the body of my son. And actually, I think that I have 100 portraits of him, yes? And I wanted, in fact, I did not only once one picture like this, but I repeat three sets of photography, the same photography, and I do different exercise with this. Only, I don't know why, only emotional, the second one, yes. And I can observe also, perhaps it's important for me, I think so, that I can observe the growing up, pictures of the several age of my son. And for example, last I made, he's 21. It's only his face. Yes, and what I wanted to explain with this, not explain, but I take this picture because I want to speak about destruction of the degradation, yes. And for me, it was a theme, and this theme, the first theme, is our own body, in fact. What we feel, it's not, we have some question to think about the problem of the degradation of the body for me. For example, the publicity show every time some beautiful girls or beautiful guy, but there is a problem with this, the sense of this, for example. I like very much Pina Bausch, for example, because the body of all the person who dance in the Pina Bausch company, yes? And second thing, I was in Moscow in the, in 94 or 95, I don't know. This is a project of Moise Ginsburg, Narcofilm, yes? And I take this picture, okay, at this moment. Why I take this picture? Because I was really interested by the degradation by this. For example, at this moment, perhaps this is a sense of a first meaning, at this moment, the municipality who was the owner of the building wanted to buy this building for 1 ruble. Yes, this was the price, and so a part of the meaning of this building, incredible building, yes? And another picture, to go in the same way, Gerrit Rietveld, I think the second house he built for driver, for, how to say, medicine, a doctor, yes, in the center of Utrecht. I like very much the sketches of Rietveld. And I was really interested by this and by this picture published everywhere. And you can see, and perhaps also it's a reason why I was interested by this, that what are the lines? These lines are panels of concrete, and on these panels of concrete, you can see a team just painted white on. It's better for, yes, I will be less tired after that. Okay. And you can see, it's better for this. You can see the little shape, white shapes, yes, that he puts on the wall of concrete. But the first time I saw this building, this house, it was like this. Yes. And everything has disappeared, but the scale, perhaps the scale, and also you can, this is not the good one. Okay, you can so here, you can see here, the proportion and so on, and the way to build, in fact, the iron pieces and so on, and in this place, just here, you can see this team, but the meaning of this building, this is the reality of this building, in fact, not what I've showed just before, and 2 months ago. I go back to Utrecht. This is a little picture of this, because I've destroyed stupidly the others. But you can see that everything is rebuilt, in fact. And it's very strange, because what's the meaning today of something so clean? It's really difficult. For example, last weekend, not yesterday, but the day before, I was in Vienna to see the Steinhoff Church of Wagner rebuilt, like new, and all the sense of the time has disappeared, for example, extremely. It is really difficult to have feeling about this building, because the reality of this building is time, 100 years, for example. Okay, and this is this book. Okay, another thing, and this is the first picture of the project I wanted to show this evening. The name of this project is House of Citizens. But before, I want to explain perhaps a conviction, something in what I believe art. It's that if I take I will make just a little scheme like this. When I try to speak about like architecture, when I try to think about it, for me, I can give this picture. When before all this material, we have slides, camera, I don't know, yes, you know, like cinema, yes? And you can see in all of cinema, this is the projector, this is the screen, and this is, yes, the cone of light, yes, with the picture. Okay, for me, I can explain a little bit architecture for me with this. The most important thing is the light. Without light, there is nothing. For me, the light is never the architect. This is the person who, the client. This person would be a person with a future, with a project in his body, and not a person, in an institution, it's the same. And this is with this energy, and this is this energy that at a moment will be architecture. And first thing. The second thing is the screen is the reality of architecture. This is really the construction. And you can understand it very well. For example, this is the time to create and to build. And sometimes that disappear. Because for somebody, the most important thing is to create, not to build, for example. Yes? And what's the dust here? In fact, this cone is really important because this is the space of, how to say, frottement en français, perhaps this person, rubbing, yes, the space of rubbing of the idea. The idea is, in fact, dangerous for the society because we, for each project, real project, we try to reveal a reality that don't exist. All the time, not only for architecture, for everything, for political way, if you want, for any idea. And the society, if the time grow up, you have more and more institutions that are around the idea. And the difficulties are really important, but reveal the system of the society. Okay, and for me, the architect put the slide. It transformed the reality of the order of the idea of the life that this person, this institution have, and make something with this. Okay, I show you because I think that architecture is the representation of the exchange, if you want. Yes, for me it's the most important thing, and I can speak about this with this strange picture because I have three like this, and I make it after the meat, after the meal. And why? Because you can see on this picture the geography of the exchange. I have 2,000 like this, I think, because each time I take the same the same stupid camera and I do it after the, I think Lee have seen it, yes, and Luke too, yes, I've taken it, yes, last weekend when I was there, I do it. Okay. Why? Because I can, for me, this picture is very interesting for me because you have a shape of the geography of the exchange, okay? And you have convention of on this, for example, convention of the how to put the table and so on, and each in several countries it's not the same, yes? And after that, you transform the reality in another thing. And with this theme, in this place, in this project, we have tried to do something. For example, we are in the center of Brussels here. You can see some towers. This is the north part of Brussels. And perhaps I can show it, yes, here. And after that, all the scale of the city broke in 1, 2, 3, 4 levels, buildings, okay? In the 70s, all the speculation here of towers, very, very important, stopped with a group of pressure of RO, I don't know if you know this group in Brussels, who make a philosophy to stop all the destruction of this part of the city. And in fact, the promoters, yes, stopped to build, but stayed the owner of all this place, but don't did anything during 20 years, 25 years. And in fact, the empty place was the property, yes, of all the inhabitants, the young boy, and so on. Near here, you have a station, one of the main stations in Brussels, with the most important prostitution part of Brussels, for example. There are gangs in this place, for example, each week, car burn, yes, a lot of aggressivity. And what the city wanted to do, and here you have, this place, it's not a park, it's nothing, yes, you know, and also a square at this place there, you can see a little school, yes, for children, and yes, and the program was to put there a program of educator, how to say, social workers that works in the streets, not in office, but in the streets, in relation with the family, with the guys, with the boys, with the girls, and so on, with all the several nationality, and so on, yes? And in the ground floor of this building, they had began, I think, 3 years before the project. And in fact, what we thought at this moment, I can show you, show you on this picture. This is the model of the first tower is here, the square is here, and you have all this place open without nothing, just for feet, but for a bicycle, but without nothing. Okay, and the degradation of all the houses were very hard, if you want. This is a project to rebuild this part, but at this moment, there is nothing here. Another project was to make a park of it and a new place. Okay. Our idea was not to build, in fact, a building, but to make first a town planning building, if you want. This is a big table. This is the possibility to build was to this point, and we occupied everything, yes? 52 meters like this. Just we take the ground and grow up five meters, yes? And after that, with this idea, we put all the program. Here, what I can show this picture, you know, where we were children, you have a glass with a dust of steel, and yes, with a magnet, you can make very beautiful things like this. And we were very interested by this. For example, we have several things in the program. An open space to do everything, a place for the gardener of the house, some offices for psychologists or something like this. There was also place for a school of the evening for the young boy, yes, of this kind of things. But how to put all this part of program? In fact, we have, this picture is better to explain. For example, here you have the school, yes. Close to the school, we put, in fact, we put the program beneath the table. But this place, here you have an open space because the father and the mother of the children can wait here. In Belgium, there are, like in London, there are a lot of rain, in fact. And it was a good place to stay and to wait the children. But when the children are there, they are already in the building, in fact. And we try to make this, to find this kind of solution, to create the opportunity of an exchange between the outside and inside of the building. And you can see it on this little scheme, because here you can throw away the building. This is this part close to the school. This is all the activities for the children here. This is the open hall here. and here all the offices. And above it, you can see, for example, the guy who preserve, who stay there, who live there, and who preserve the security of all the building. Why? Because there are another man who do the same job in the school, for example. And at this moment, this is the profile of this building, and with the double level of the big hole here. And also, you can see some link between the top of the table and the square, for example. I can explain in this picture, I think. Not this one, this one, yes. For example, this is the plan of the table. And for us, we have opportunities with this place, 5 meters above the other, to put there, for example, the market, a part of the market, in the building itself. And or to create events, or to have sports place for the school, yes. And to the idea was also to try to find tools to create exchange between the neighborhood and the building too. And you can see it also in this first scheme because. You have also a point. On one line, you can see everything here, for example, with the activity of the building. Yes, and in these pictures there, what we can find is on these photos, we can find the publicity of three parts. Yes, with the same, you can have three publicities. And we wanted to reserve one of them for public communication, yes? And but we are also interested by another thing. In fact, we called a friend, not a friend of mine, but no, yes, but not at this moment. I call, not this moment, because I know it, I don't know him at this moment. He's an artist, his name is Johan Meul, and Johan Meul make a strange work, and for example, he tried to define the, how to say, different behaviors of the society about, for example, the publicity. And for him, publicity would be, and we talked together about this project, would be a possibility to create a link between the young boy and the building, for example. Yes? And also, what we liked together was the noise of all this panel who do each minute something like this. And we propose it to the city, to the municipality, but the day before they have created a rule that stopped all the publicity in the city. We don't realize it. Okay. And for example, we propose, this is this place. And we propose to have the possibility to create a new link of bus, for example, line of bus. This is the realization. And you can see first, the first sketch of the park and the place. But you can see also that everything is broken everywhere. It's very, very hard, this part, in fact. But also that you have possibility to play here and to play there. Okay. I asked a friend of mine, a woman, Marie-Françoise Plissard, who makes this picture 5 years ago at the end of the building. Yes, with the possibility to go to the top of the building. This is the top, and with a five stars hotel. The 5 stars hotel was also a big problem for the citizens there, in fact, with the big cars in the poorest part of Brussels. Yes, this is the inside, and for example, we have created this place. You can close it with doors of garage, for example, yes, very simple. And with this picture, they asked us also to make a club project inside, but I show you very quickly because no sense for me. Yes, and in fact, last week, not last week, but 2 months ago, Brett speak about this project of lecture, and I asked again Marie-Françoise Pissard, the same photographer, to go there and to take picture. In fact, I have two ideas. The first one, to take a picture again of the destruction, not the destruction, the fact, what is the reality of this building now, for example, this one. The aggressivity on windows are really important. And for example, you can see here the glue, the black glue, yes, for the panel in wood that they have to put to preserve the building. It's very, very hard. Yes, and I asked her because also I wanted to not observe by myself, but observe by her what arrived. And first thing, I don't go there. I just order the photography. And after that, I go there for the second thing. And the second thing was to create an appointment with 10 persons, around 10 persons, to speak about, to answer to question, to put the question, why the destruction, why each part you can observe, for example, a little part was burned, why this part burned, for example, and to observe the meaning of each sequence of aggressivity. Okay, and to do it, I ask 10 persons, the three first were in fact the social workers, yes, of the institution. And after that, the head of the police station, yes, somebody with very long hair, big beard, or something like this, strange guy, but very clever, in fact. And also three sociologists, one political philosopher, yes, one historian, and one person of the municipality who has the chief of the department of the public housing. For example, if we need to make new glasses, this is her budget. Okay, and I do it to make an appointment where nobody will be there to observe, but everybody has to speak, or he don't come. Yes, to try to find the sense, the reason of what appear, and I've write some of them, and for me it was really interesting to do this. In fact, and last week when I was in London, I go in Whitechapel. Yes, and I've seen also the EDH store of Ajay. For me, it's the same reality than us, something like this. And for example, when we begin to build this building in an area where there were nothing, no construction, no public construction, no new pavement, for example, nothing. A new building was so aggressive by the fact that it's a new building that they take a brick and threw it on the wall, in the glass. Okay, the second one, that the girls and boys from 10 to 20, 22, they are not children of the war, but they are children of two decades and a half of building. Of nothing, or all the what they did was to play there in this place, and this building was on their place to play. They take a brick and threw up on the building. Okay. Another fact is this building at the end was really new. He speak by himself. I'm new. They take a brick and put it in the wall. After that, the building was not understanding for them, because this is not a traditional building. It's impossible to understand very well. this building? What's this? There is no real facade. What's this roof? Why concrete? Why bricks? Why? And they take a brick and put it in the wall. Okay. After that, another thing, it's that for most of the young boy, this was a beautiful place to play before the windows. Yes, sure, all the evening and after the school and so on. But when we put the glasses, they take a brick and put it in the glass. Okay. After that, another thing is, for example, just before this house, there was a place for your house or something like the IFCA or something like this, I don't know. In French, maison de jeunes, house for youth. Yeah. Yes? Okay. And but 3 months before the opening of this place, the young boy was killed by another one with a knife. Yes? They stopped the house for youth. Yes? And after that, all these children, after the opening, come there because the name of this building is House of Citizens. But it's not exact, in fact. This is not house for all the citizens, for example, not for these guys, because it's too dangerous. This place has had other missions to do. And the name is not good. It's the reason why this young boy take a break and put it in the glass too. Okay, and another problem, is, for example, you can observe that this is the first building since 25 years, the first new building, public building. But during the same time, there are a lot of discussion with new developments for all the plots, yes, around all the neighborhood. But the politics don't do very well the concertation, the discussion with the population. For example, they take high level, and it was impossible to have discussion about the high level of the building. But you can speak about the color of the bank, of the seats. Yes, of the seats. And they take a brick because aggressivity grow up and up in the new building, the only one. And also, another thing very important for me that I have heard, that I discovered, was that, in fact, a big problem are the windows. Why? Because from inside, all the social workers are afraid because everybody from outside saw them. Okay. For example, they are in the office, and a young boy came and take a piece of steel and go to the car and open the car and take all the things in the car. What to do? If they go to police, for example, the social workers go to the police to explain, they are the police too. That it's finished with the population. If they don't do it, they credit, they are okay with this practice. And I remember 1 year ago or 2 years ago, they call me, they phone me, and they say, Pierre, we need to have curtains. Why to have curtains? To don't see. To close them. And no relation. It's a very big problem. Another one is for the young boys around, because for them, they are observed and controlled by the social workers inside. Mm-hmm. And this is a strange feeling. But now, 5 years later, I think 3, 4 months or 5 months later, the square and the park were open. Finally, and there is no bricks on the ground to put in the, yes? And also, the real life of this building appear. And there is new project that will appear now, and we have decided to continue this discussion, if you want. Not only for me to try to do something with this project and continue something with all these persons, but also to try to find the meaning of what I do. Also, because a competition is, this is a very big distance between the users and the creators, very big distance. And yes, it was what I wanted to explain. I have some pictures about it. Yes, for example, This is a shelter for the bicycle, but also a beautiful goal. the best of this place in the city just plays between, it's stupid, between two windows. Yes, this one, for example. You can see all the football balloon there. Okay, this is the third part of the place, of the square. This is the park too, and a painting that they have created 2 months ago. Yes, for example, the photographer sent me this picture with all this guy. You can see they don't want it to be photography, but I like very much the other. Yes, we are above on the top of the on the roof. You can see all these women. This is a lesson to cook. Yes, you know, for these women, and they hidden themselves everywhere. You know, yes, okay. But this one and this one, see, look immediately to the camera. Yes, proud. Okay, the boy. Okay, at this moment, I want to show you the second part of what I wanted to explain this evening. It's six projects that we built. And we are in the center of a little city of 70,000 persons in the west of Belgium. The name of the city is Mons. You can see, yes, the shape of the ancient city. And across here, this is our project in the biggest plot of all the city, because in this city was a city for the army, if you want, yes, with a lot of soldiers. For example, in this place, there is a place only for the army, 5,000 persons, 5,000 houses, for example, just before the Second World War. And in this place, there is a riding school, an old riding school. Oh, perhaps I can show it. Yes, this one, an old riding school. And the Ministry of Culture wanted to transform it in a theater of creation. Theater of creation, you need not only the big play, big hall for the plays, but also another one to repeat and to create new new plays inside the building. And with a very cheap, very, very cheap building. And in fact, we have this panel in the place here in the AA. This is one of the panel of the competition. On this panel, you can see, for example, that we try to, perhaps I have better slides. I will have a look. Ah, yes, okay. I explained another thing. On this panel, you can see that at the end of the project, we have, this is our project, I will explain, but at the end of the project, we were here on a strange plot, because only some buildings here and here was created, if you want, but all the center of the plot was empty, yes, without program, and till 20 years or something like this. And for me, it was absurd to create a theater without a project for all the neighborhood, if you want. And we propose some new places. I have not the time to explain everything, but we propose some new program. And the jury decided to that we won the prize, but the project. But 1 week after, the city council, if you want, asked us to develop a plan, and we have do it. And actually, we have most of the projects are under construction. Also, what I wanted to show with this picture, you can see the development of the project, the position, in fact, of the main place to make theater, in fact. This is the black box, but this idea is stupid because I put the black box on the old building. But inside the old building, the space was very beautiful, in fact, very, very well built, like army can do it, very strong, but precise and so on, so very interesting. And you know that after, it's the same than here, after the three shock, you make the black and you can see anything. Yeah? Okay. And after that, we try to put this black box outside. This is the second idea. But we speak with the scenographer, yes, the specialist of scenography. And for them, it was a good idea, but not good enough, because I wanted to have something more simple to put all the frame in steel for the theater. And I do something like this. It was not enough. I continue the project like this to prove that it was almost absurd to continue like this. Also, because it was impossible to see the meaning of this project, for example. It's impossible to see that this is a theater, for example. And also, there is no relation between the black box, because the black box don't need windows or nothing, no sense, to put this in relation with this part of the city without nothing at this moment. And it's the reason why I try to inverse in two steps. I try to inverse and to put, and to put the public at this place. And I remember a building I saw in Moscow 10 years ago of Melnikov. And I was really interested by the well-known Ruzakov building, not because it was proud or this was clever, for example, but because my feeling was that the real materiality of this house, of this building, was not concrete or was not glass, but was the conviction of Melnikov. He believed in this state of society, and with this, he think that it was possible to do it with the very poor industry of building in Russia at this moment. And it was something like this in our head when we try to imagine this project. Alors, yes, for this project, I can illustrate it by this. What we try to do, you have the old building like this, and we want we put, in fact, the main place to play here, yes, the main hall to play, and all the public here, and we put a glass of coat around. Why? Because you can go to find your seat, and this is for the exit for fire, for example, yes, and you can see everybody who go there. And it's very important because theater is a ritual where all the body are very important, sometimes more important than the place itself, yes? And it was a reason why we try to do it. But also, we make this little model with plexiglass, just like, yes, one shape, if you want. And after that, we try to stay with this idea, to keep this idea, and to create. And perhaps you can see it on the here. You can see some windows, some glasses are free to seize if you want, and the other I trouble. Yes. And also on this picture, what I wanted to explain is that the building is very cheap. I come back to Melnikov and the structure, very simple. How to do something like this, not without money, but with not a lot of money. In fact, we work for this project with our engineer. Our engineer is Greish, has built, for example, the bridge Milo of Foster, yes? And in fact, the most activity of this engineer are bridges, yes? And for example, here, their idea was to, and I only want to speak about these two walls in the few pictures there. Here, in fact, they decided to make a wall of concrete of 25 centimeters for all the weight. It was very, very thin. Why? Because they put inside a piece of steel, yes? And they made the straight after, yes, just after. And with this, we don't need a lot of concrete to do it. Mm-hmm. And also, you have strange a strange way to make, if I make a section, for example, like this, yes, you have the two, yes, the main, I go something like this, the main walls, and from the top of the roof, you have the lines of iron, yes, to take the windows, and in the same way, you take, how to say in English, it's difficult for me. I hope you understand. This is like in the jungle, you have all the branches, yes? It's something like this. And you don't need a lot of section to do it. It's very, very cheap to create this skin of the building. Okay, this is the models of this. For example, we can two plates of 20 centimeter by two. This is the pictures around the entrance. A beautiful place to smoke because we don't it's forbidden to smoke inside the building now with the new law. Yes, what I have explained. And also the second thing that we try to do with this building and that I wanted to show is that for acoustic inside the building, in fact, our project was with the other section. You can see it there. With the other section, this is the main place with the persons are there, yes, is to take the noise, the voice here. And this is the absorption are in the seats, it's normal, and the reflection are in the ceiling. But with the walls, what we wanted to do is to not absorb but diffuse the yes the in fact to diffuse. You have the arrows of noise when it arrive on the wall, make something like this. Is to make something like this to be diffused. And there is a shape of the wall, if you want, but not the same with, for example, the weight of, I think, 2050. You have a kind of profile, but with 8050, you have another profile, more like this. And here, we have tried to, in a laboratory, to try to find the good shape for the diffusion for all the levels of noise, if you want. And our idea was to give the skin inside, yes, the decoration, I don't know, I hate this term, but yes, the what you can see of the wall inside the theater, to give all the this representation to the acousticians, yes. And this is the different research. The first concrete panel. In fact, the black is made by the dust of fire, you know, the black one. When you make a fire, you take this black dust of fire and put it in the concrete. Yes, this is this place. A second project. This is a little bank in the thoughts of Brussels. This is close to Namur. Brett, you can say if it's too longer. Yes, okay. And you have on this map, you can see, for example, this is one of the main entrance of the city. Okay, this is the best place for the bank agency, because there are a lot of traffic, and for them, this is the best place, okay. But in fact, you can see this street, for example, it's not beautiful, but just in the background, you have the landscape. This landscape is really beautiful, in fact. And our idea was with the first organigram like this, we discovered that the self-banking was a little place, in fact. For the self-banking, you don't need a lot of place. But in the back, but behind, we need a lot of place for all the the offices, if you want, yes? And this place can be beautiful if you put it close to the landscape too. And in this little scheme, you can try, for example, that the plan is the same that the section, yes? And with this shape, we have decided to open everything in this axe and to close everything around, yes? In the, yes, like a box like this. You can see it better here, and perhaps better here. This is the central space, for example. This is like an old camera for me with some, yes, profile of glasses. And it was really important for us because we think that with the light we can do a lot of things in this project. And you can see also some research to try to find the best one for the material that we wanted to use outside with a sense of weight. Yes, and also not only to find the good, how to say, material, but to create a tool for us to feel the sense of the material, if you want, only to feel it, because we don't want it to do it in wood, for example, but we do it in wood to sense the sensuality of the material, if you want. This is the model. And at this moment, we ask an artist, Pierre Toby, to create, to imagine something with the light, with the sense of the light through all the building. You can see some of this his research here, and in the exhibition you have other research of him. This is the also a possibility for us to put it on a circle, yes, and the so the volume is freer. More free. This is at last week. This is almost the end of this building. Yes. Here we are in the north of Liège. In fact, Liège, the city of Liège where I lived and where I work, is close to the borders of Netherlands here and Germany here. For example, from here, 3 kilometers. Very close. And in this place, a Dutch man asked me to build a house. And Brett says to me that he liked a model there, and I choose this project to explain. Because what I wanted to explain is not this model, but a strange story. You can see here pictures, painting, aquarelle of Turner in this place, one century and a half, something like this. And also, this is an old city of Vizé here. And well, on this place was something like a castle, but almost destroyed. And we decided to destroy it and to rebuild something. And our first idea, because if he had bought this castle, it was because for him he needs to be really protected, for example, explained to us, I need to be really protected to have a very high level or something like this, and something like a totem. And I was the fifth architect to work with him, because it's not easy, this guy. Two Dutch architects and two German one has tried to work with him. And you can see the development, very little here, but I begin to make just the first proposition was to put a box in a surrounding like this. But at the end, the last shape was something like a sculpture, if you want. You can see it inside, what is inside and what is outside. Yes, everything, the project was to build everything in bricks, even the roof. A brick industrial one that we used a lot in this part of Belgium. But at this moment, with this project, this person come to me and says to me, oh, Pierre, it's really good. For the first time, I think that I'm hurt. Yes, I'm hurt. And it's the reason why I want that you take this project and yet that you put it on the ground like this. Okay, everything was broken. And after that, the problem was how to do with the feeling that something is broken. You have an idea, you believe in an idea, and after that, everything is on the ground, really on the ground. And how to do. In fact, it's something like the same problem, not in the same way, but perhaps to take an exhibition in Paris and to put in here the same exhibition with the same pieces here in the AA, how to not lost really the vitality of a project. It's a problem. For example, the Black Book was an opportunity for us to, the book published by AA was an opportunity for us to make something with more authenticity, if you want. And also, and I thank you, AA, for this, the possibility to put other things, other objects of our exhibition, not only in the main space, but for example, the model of the research, of the scenography of here, the exhibition, with our publishing, the books of our publishing house in the bookshop, or to put something on the terrace, or to put something in the bar. It's important for us, in fact, in this way. Okay. And here, how to do? In fact, I decided not to take my pencil, to stop my pencil, and just to cut art paper, the shape of art paper, with the square meters of each part of the project, and put it on a big model. We made a very big model of all the place where we have to put this project. And after that, after some time, I have this idea to put it on the different levels of the ground, but also to open hardly the ground floor and to inverse the gravity, to put closed boxes above, okay? And with both, I begin to find perhaps a solution also to develop another skyline and how to build it, in fact. First, I think the possibility will be to put boxes on boxes, if you want. But after that, I think that it will be also something like the same material everywhere with some holes or something like this. But and at the end, my idea was to make something like musical with, like you write music, yes, do you know, between links. You have all the development of the project, for example. And with this, I can make sequences like sequence in music. I was more interested by this. Mm-hmm. This is the plan of the ground floor and the position of the different rooms above the model that you can observe in the other place. And here we are in Brussels, in the south of Brussels. This is a place where you have beautiful streets in the garden, in the woods, and what this person have found was this house. But in fact, they called to me. They called me and they said, "Pierre, we have found Mr. Hebbelinck at this moment. We have found a house, but we don't like it. But perhaps, we like this place, in fact, but we don't like this house. But perhaps we can do something with this, or perhaps we have to broken it, or something like this." Okay. As I explained also their budget. And it was difficult to make something, to broke everything, because there was a difference of level between the streets and the main place to build. And underground, there was also a garage and some place interesting to stay. But my idea, you can see the building is here. And perhaps on this game, it's more easy to explain. Yes, I'm looking for the, yes, in my hand. Okay, here you have the plot. And the old building was something like this. And the West was here, thought, and East. And you have no place for the evening, for example. Everything was close to the border here of the plot. And my idea was to stay, to keep part of the house. And for example, I show you this picture of Mondrian. You know it very well. But what I like in this picture, for example, this development of the 13 or something like this, 1913 or 14, was that this is a part of an infinite. All lines continues. Each color continues, in fact. You have a window on something that is infinite. And in this project, also, I was really interested by this project of Aldo Van Eyck, because you can see, for example, that in this way, in this direction, you can see through all the building. And in the other section, you have sequences. You can see some parts. And I like it very much. It's the reason why I began to make this first research. In red, you can see the old building, only the first level. I destroyed the second one and the roof. And also, this is the entrance. And you can see in this axe everything. And in the other direction, you refine sequences. It's the same in the second project. But in fact, at this moment, we try to create a model. But the model proved that it was very strange. The shape, in fact, rejected the environment because it was something with a center. But what is outside, there is no sense with the outside parties, if you want. And I tried to make something like this to cut in the body of the first project. And you can see all the bedrooms are there, for example, the living room here is very easy. And at the end, I arrived at something like a pentangle, free pentangle, yes, the first model with the roof. And we tried to do it in aluminium, in fact. This is the different technical plan. Yes, because the construction is almost wet, if you want, only in aluminium. And this is the realization of the building. But I wanted to explain another thing. For example, here you have windows, you can see it, but here you have windows too. I can show it, for example, here with this door. And what I try to do, in fact, I really Czech photographer Joseph Sudek. This is a photography of 1945 of Joseph Sudek. Joseph Sudek was, in fact, in the beginning of the century, she was somebody who make bread. I don't know the name of this. Yes, baker. Thank you. He was a baker, but he lost his one arm during the First World War. And after that, he became a photographer. And during the Anschluss and since, I think, 38, he have almost no material. And he begin to think that he can do one thing, to make photography through his window. And sometime, he was waiting 6 months to have the good dust. And after that, it clicked. It's fantastic because if you see all this collection of photography, you can see anything in the same way. It's impossible because the time was really important for each picture. Okay, and we wanted to do something with intimacy, with intimacy, I don't know. Yes, intimacy. And try to find a way with this. It's the reason why you have two skins, one in glass, another one with little holes in plates of aluminium. Okay, and also we ask a photographer to do this photography, and in fact, she chose to make it during 4 months. In fact, this is traveling. I think I have a book here. We have published a book about this. This is this one. And in this book, you can see the development. I have to, because the micro, I think. But yes, I can open it. Oh, this picture, I think, is here. Without this, it's better. I need a table to do it and so on. Yeah, you can find the traveling, because you have the first picture, this one. This is outside. You can see it. And the other one, you are 4 meters. You can see the inside. This is the same traveling, yes? And we have do it 8 times, I think. But you can see, for example, I don't know on this picture, but perhaps in the other one, on this one, for example, you can see the girl, the little girl, or the little boy here and there. And for example, the boy is here, the boy is there, and the girl is here. But so on some of this picture, this is not the same girl, for example, because he's 4 months more, yes, older. Hmm? Yes. Okay, on this picture, we are in Mons again, the same city than in the beginning. And I wanted to show you this project for tourism. This is an old school of the 30s, beautiful one, in fact, but very poor with the structure, too light for the structure. But the Ministry of Culture wanted to create there the permanent storage of the pieces of art, of 5,000 pieces of art, for the Ministry of Culture. Okay, and this was also a competition, and we proposed to put all the most important weight and the most important sizes of dimension of rooms in just a tower to liberate the other part. And on this project, you can see the model of inside with the original structure in the concrete, very beautiful, I like it very well. And in fact, we have tried in this project to open some space, for example here, to photograph the biggest piece of work, piece of art. And also, I've exhibited these little boxes, jewel boxes of my grandfather here in the bar, I think. You can see it. Why? Because what the Ministry of Culture wanted to make was not only something with a lot of security for the pieces of art, but with an expression about what is this. It's not a school, in fact. This is another program. And I think with this box, what I have feeling, if I close it, for example, I know it very well that in this box, there is something with art value, if you want. But it's impossible to detect what value. And with this mystery, with this paradox, perhaps we can try to find a solution. And in fact, we begin to, we try to work on the main facade with a material who is created not for facade, but for floors, if you want. It's more heavy, and with the development is very important. For example, this is very great. Wait, I don't know. I lost my words. this is several research of the artist Jean Glibert. And Jean Glibert has an idea to put the colors not outside, but inside. For example, this is a prototype that we put on the facade, and all the colors are inside. And during the night, everything appears. This is other research of him. Yes, and during the night, everything appears. And you can see through the cathedral glass, for example, the diffusion of the color. For each of our project, we try to find with an artist to develop the reflection about spaces and so on. And this is the last project I will show to you this evening. We are in the fronts of Liège, where you have green valley with very important rocks or something like this, very beautiful place. And there, the most younger couple asked me to build a house, in fact, a very little one of 100 square meters, very, very little, but almost without budget. And I give them two conditions. The first one was to follow us, the most important. And the second one was to work with family economy, because the father of the man is a firm of steel plates to fabricate chimney, for example, or something like this. And this is this village. And the place is something like here. And in fact, I have a little problem with this project. I have lost, I know. I can show you on the board here. A little problem. If we have no economy, I've had this problem a lot of time. For example, here, you have the street, and the level of the ground is here to build. And the difference was 4 meters. But for a little project without budget, this is a real problem. And I propose to cut just a place to put the car, yes, and on these two rails to build a prefabricated house, if you want. And you can see the development here. This is very simple, in fact, what I try to explain. But in fact, because it's a cube, this is the most simple shape to build. For example, here we build it. This is the detail on the sheet of restaurant, for example. And this is a prototype. First time in my life I can do a prototype. 3 meter of, yes, a cube of 3 meters. Yes, this is also important because during the night we take the different part of the house. And in fact, what is important in this project, first thing is the way to build, in fact. For example, this is the structure are the plates. This is not beams of steel, and after that, a plate on it with nails. It's not this way. It's something like a boat, in fact, yes? And we work with 20 engineers to do it. Some come from Paris for this little house because there are no, at this moment, we have no example of this. And there are a lot of problems with the dimension of, yes, of the steel with the heels or, I don't know, the problem of water, yes, not outside only, but inside too, and so on. And in fact, also, we imagine the sizes of the project with, this is the place where we built the different part of the project, the fourth part of the project, the firm, the industry, and this is the place where we have to build, and we try to find the way, the cheapest way to go there between bridges and so on, yes? And this is the best dimension of each element, the lost, the less expensive to do it, yes? That gives the size of the house. And in one day, in fact, this photo was taken at 5 o'clock. In one day, 7 hours. We build a house, okay. But, and this is the last thing I want to explain. The day after, at 8, I heard in the radio that the city wanted to broke the house, okay. Okay, because I think it was a shock for all the neighborhood with this building. And in fact, you can see also other pictures like this. This is, the building is built. Now, yes, with these colors, and inside, everything is free. You can, all the, we has the opportunity to design all the furnitures, for example, yes. And what appear, in fact, at 10, my advisor, the lawyer, says to me, Pierre, keep quiet, it's impossible to destroy this building because you have the permission to do, permit to do it, and so on, and so on. But it was not enough for me, in fact. And an half hour later, I asked all my team to come with me. and to discuss, and we created a publishing house. And this is the first book we did at this moment. Why? Because we have so much idea to create architecture, and we don't find places anywhere to explain all these things, in fact, because in the repartition, the division, the evolution of the Belgian country, you have three regions today. 40 years ago, you have a central power, but actually you have three regions. And for example, the Flemish part, the Brussels one, and the Walloon part. And in the, for example, the cultural development are not the same in all the different regions. For example, in Wallonia, in Wallonie, on Walloon part, we have developed the culture for the film, for example. The Frères d'Ardenne, you know, Cannes, and so on. There are a lot of things for the filmmaker, but for architecture, zero. And this is the inverse in the Flemish part, for example. Why? Because the Flemish government has decided that their identity will be developed by the way of architecture, the signification of architecture. And the first time a Ministry of Culture take a position for the architecture of creation in the Walloon part, yes, the Walloon part of Belgium, was in 2005, 4 years ago. But without ministry, without politics, you have no diffusion. You have no journalist, nothing in the press, daily press, for example. And it was so hard that we decided to make to give us the possibility to be more free, in fact, and to have not the control, but to have our pleasure to create will be only, not only in architecture, but also with books. And the first one, in fact, the idea was to make a book, very little one, yes, 5 centimeter, a cube of 5 centimeter. And with this book, in fact, our idea was to, and this is the name of our publishing house, the name of our publishing house, it's very difficult to translate, but this is Fourtou Edition. Fourtou is the name of when you are children and you go to school, you have a pocket to put your pencil, yes? You have two models, in fact. The first one, you have rubber or something like this, and you put it everything is in order, everything is okay, yes? And the other one, this is a pocket, and you put everything in it. This is a 4-2. Why 4-2? Because we take all the material of our creations, what we have, the photography, but also the models, the picture of the models, the map, the sheet of restaurant, of, I don't know, a lot of things, yes? The text, yes, the letters, and so on. You put it everything on the table, and after that, we try to imagine a book. I've shown this one, for example, it was a third. But this one, this is the first. And in fact, what we try to do here is to try to find a solution also with the articulation of the book, because it was impossible to do it, for example, with a simple traditional binding. Impossible, that broke immediately. We have tried and put and through okay, and test it in the Atelier. It was impossible. And but the idea comes not for us, but for the printer, who said to us, "Yes, it's like for the colors, you know, Pantone or something like this. You can do it." And in one hand, you can find all the conception, for example, all the sketches, all the plans, and so on. And in the other hand, you have an extract of the 1,200 photography of simple guy who would go there, who are interested by it, and who send us the photography in real time, because by internet everything is in real time, and we choose 200 pictures to only to show the different moments of the building before, yes, we take the ground with, yes, you know, the beginning, to till the not this moment, but the day where we built in 7 hours the building. It was the first book. Okay, I speak a lot of things. Thank you very much for this evening.
As I said to everyone as we started, we've got a book launch in here, so I think it best that you all get a chance to meet Pierre and talk about the work. There are several issues I think that have come up through it. I think rather than take more time with questions now, why don't you all just join us right in the South Jury Room here around the corner. You can ask Pierre your questions in person. He'll take off the microphone. You can have a conversation. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you. Thanks. Thank you, Brett.